Creating your own custom locks for FNC blocks has never been easier. You can now create custom paths with links to create your own blocks. Before I dip into the code, let's have a look at the demo. On the right, you see all the blocks that are available in one custom block we defined using a path. In addition to the path, we also define that there are 1, 2, 3 possible link points that we can click. I can click here, here, and here to connect other blocks to this block. Be mindful of the fact that it's also easy to register these new blocks that you create into the existing architecture of block selection. Let's have a look at the code, how it all works. You will be surprised how easy it is. On the surface, we have the blocks control and the blocks selector. This is where the blocks framework automatically generates all the component blocks that are available. Looking at the code, you see that we define the end port block and derive it from the FNC blocks block class. We have to specify a constructor to initialize the block, and we have to provide the path. Alternatively, you can also provide a vector image, which is shown in another video. So looking at the path that we provide, you see that TMS provides an API that allows you to build the shape of the block. The procedure getBlockPath gets a reference to the path of the block. You can call methods similar to the canvas of the VCL to draw the shape of your block. Start by calling apath.reset. Let's have a look at all the methods that are available using code completion. Apath dot, we have arcs, Bezier curves, curves, ellipses, lines, polygons, rectangles, and we also have the ability to close figures automatically. There are plenty more methods and functionality that you can check out in the product documentation. So looking back at the end port block, we use lines, close the figure, we use arcs, which is the right side of the control, and we also add links, but that is done in the constructor, where we initialize the size, the height and width of the block, and also set where the links are supposed to be created. So here you see the 3 links that are being created. Be sure to initialize the link points using clear to not use any of the link points that might be inherited. And that is almost as much as you need to do. One thing is missing, of course. Just creating a class that you derive from the block base class doesn't suffice. You also need to register that block in the ecosystem of FNC blocks. And you do that calling register element. Specify the class, if you want an element ID, the caption of the block, and of course, the category for the selector. So it's also possible to define your own categories in the selector control. And if you wonder how this gets called, the blocks control has an event which is called onRegisterElements. So before the control is being initialized, this is getting called. So you have the shot to register all your custom blocks. So this is all it takes to create custom blocks using paths. Also, please refer to the product documentation to read about all the different drawing opportunities in detail. If you're not using FNC blocks already, and this has been the feature you've been waiting for, just go to fnc.tmssoftware.com and download a trial today.